Sachin, in last classes we have studied all the metals and non-metals differences. I told physical and different chemical differences. Today I want to see some exceptions. So, Sachin, I was telling you that metals are generally solids. Okay, and they are liquids. They are gases. Generally, they are gases, and they are hard. I told, and they are soft. I told, and they have high density. I told. Okay, they have high density electrode and they have low density electrode. Okay, and I told they are lustrous. Okay, and I said they are not non-lustrous, means they don't shine, and they are sonorous acid, and they are non-sonorous, they don't shine. I said they don't shine. Okay, and they are good conductors of heat and electricity. I told they are bad conductors of heat and electricity. I told. Okay, chill. They are bad conductors of heat and electricity. I told. Okay, then what else I told, children? Okay, and I told that they are have high MP and high BP. I told they have high MP and high BP. They have low MP and low BP. I told, children. I hope you all remember all these things. Differences. I conducted test also, and I told they are malleable. They are non-malleable. I said. They are ductile, I said. They are non-ductile. These are the differences. We just not like I will say exceptions, children. Metals are solids. Please mute your devices, children. Metals are solid except what is a liquid metal? Liquid metal. What is a liquid metal? Mercury. What is a liquid metal, children? Mercury. Symbol is Hg. You should remember. One more question. What is a liquid metal? You know mercury. You might have seen in thermometers, okay? And also you might have seen in BP apparatus mercury, okay? Liquid. And almost all non-metals are gases. Some of them are liquids. Which is the liquid non-metal? Bromine. Which is a liquid non-metal? Bromine. Okay. And which is a solid non-metal? Which is a solid non-metal? Most of the carbon isotopes, sulfur, phosphorus, all these are solid non-metals. Okay. Carbon, sulfur, phosphorus. Exceptions. Today only exceptions I am discussing. Exceptions. Okay, you should remember all these exceptions for one mark. And they're generally hard. Solids are generally hard, but there are some soft metals. Like if you take sodium and potassium, you can cut with knife like a cake, children. You can cut with knife. What are the two metals we can cut with knife? Means you have to say sodium and potassium. What do you say, children? You have to say sodium and potassium. All of you, I hope you are writing copy that. Okay, and they are generally soft except, okay, diamond, if you see, children, diamond is very hard. Okay, all of them are also hard only, but diamond is in fact hardest on the earth. Nothing else is, even metals are also, none of them is so hard than diamond. Diamond is hard. Okay, children, and they are lustrous, I said. They are non-lustrous. Okay, but if you take, iodine is a non-metal which is lustrous. Iodine is a lustrous non-metal. Iodine is a lustrous non-metal. Okay, they are good conductors of heat and electricity. They are bad conductors. I say, who is the best conductor on the earth, children? Silver. The best conductor on the earth is silver. Then copper, children. And who is the bad conductor among metals? Lead is bad conductor, children. And non-metals, children, they are generally bad conductors. But graphite, if you take, they are the good conductor. Please mute your audios, children. Graphite is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Why? Means it has one free electron. Nandika, mute your audio. Why? Means it has one free electron. Okay, children. Non-metals are generally bad conductors, but only graphite, which is a good conductor. Okay, children. All these exceptions you should write neatly, children. Okay, please. Okay. And they have high MP and high BP. Normally, because they are solids, no, children. You require high temperatures to melt them or boil them. But except cesium and gallium. Cesium and gallium, children, they have low melting points. They even melt in your palms, children. What are the two metals which can melt in your palms? With cesium and gallium. Melting point is low. They can melt in your hands by taking the body of your heat, children. Okay, by taking the heat from your body, they melt in your palms. Cesium and gallium are the metals which melt in your palms because they have low MP, low BP. These are the exceptions. You should know those, children. All of you, please copy them, children. I'm giving 10 seconds time to copy. Okay, some more exceptions are also there. These exceptions, if you know for this 10th class level, 8th class level, it is enough, children. All of you copy fast, then I will stop the recording. First, you copy all of you. If you have any doubts, ask me after I stop recording. Okay, children, if you have any doubts, now you ask.